The outside world became aware of the Daomi Amazons largely through French interaction. After the French and their African allies, the Senegalese, Hausa, and Yoruba, all rallied to conquer Daomi, they venerated the all-female fighting battalion, proclaiming that the African Amazon warriors gave proof of incredible courage and audacity. They became so popular that their glorious legend went on to survive in modern-day fiction with the arrival of Black Panther and the Dora Milaje. Even though the Amazons were saddened by the loss of Daomi to the French and their African allies, one Daomi Amazon warrior, taken in the slave trade, made sure that the wrath of the Amazons would have the final say against the French and the Haitian Revolution. What up, African world? It's Home Team here, and I'm back at it with another video of African history, culture, and worldview. And as always, if you want to support the Home Team, you can do so on Patreon.com. I have some new rewards for you guys, so be sure to check that out. And all links to Patreon and Home Team merchandise are in the description box below. Today, I wanted to talk about a brave warrior woman named Adbariah Toya, also known as Victoria Manto. Adbariah Toya was said to have fought in the war against the French in Haiti. But more importantly, she is said to have been an important figure in the life of Jean-Jacques Dessalines, the leader of the Haitian Revolution and the first ruler of an independent Haiti. The Haitian Revolution, for whatever reason, is probably one of the most avoided topics in diaspora history. And ironically, it's the most glorious moment in our history as Afro-centered people in the New World. It not only freed a group of enslaved people, but it even forced France to sell land to America in the Louisiana Purchase. The Haitian Revolution was an absolutely huge moment in human history, as it was the only successful slave rebellion in world history that went on to form a state, and to think that an African woman was at the center of it all. To truly understand Adbariah Toya, we have to understand a little bit about the history of the Daomi Amazons. To begin, the term Amazon is a European term referring to women warriors. The women warriors of Daomi were called by multiple names throughout their history, but seemingly more consistently referred to as the Mino, literally meaning our mothers. One of the reasons they were called the Mino is because the kingdom of Daomi itself was formed due to the horrors of other larger and more powerful kingdoms preying on Daomi for slaves. The Fon people of Daomi had an extreme reaction to this because they were in an extreme situation, and so literally, mothers of enslaved children and other sympathizing women would either volunteer or be recruited to fight their enemies. So the very nature of the Mino was to resist and protect. And so, no Mino soldier was going to bend the knee to injustice. The first documented definite use of the Mino as soldiers was in 1729 when the female warriors conquered the kingdom of Whydah. Whydah being a very popular slave trading center. The sources tell us that King Agaja ordered a great number of women to be armed like soldiers and appointed officers to watch company with colors, drums, and umbrellas, symbols of rank, according to the Negro fashion. Then, ordering the army to march, the women soldiers were placed in the rear to prevent discovery. When they came in sight of the Whydah army, the latter were much surprised to see such numbers of Daomi soldiers, as they supposed them all to be, marching against them. The conquering of Whydah was probably one of the first major military campaigns for the Mino. Given this history and their popularity, we're gifted with some of the names of the Mino, and I thought it fitting to speak the names of these women who came before Adbariah Toya, the woman who passed down their bravery, strength, and knowledge of warfare. Knowledge that went on to aid the success of the Haitians during their war with the French and others. These women are Sedonghongbe, Naui, Sufignan, and Tata Ajache. Sedonghongbe was a 19th century leader of the Mino who led an all-female army reportedly consisting of 6,000 warriors. Naui was said to be the last surviving Mino who told stories about the bravery of the Mino against the French. Sufignan was a general within the Mino army and one of the beloved wives of King Gezo who led her troops in conquering the capital of Mahi country. And Tata Ajache was a very young Mino warrior who was seen in battle taking a knife away from an enemy and killing him with his own weapon. The names of these brave women survive with us today because of their spectacular stories, and it's because of them that we know Adbaraya Toya as she pulled from this same ancestral energy. So who is Adbaraya Toya? Adbaraya Toya was reportedly a member of the legendary Mino from Dayomi. She was a well-trained soldier, but unfortunately, given the history of slave raids in Dayomi, she got captured by a rivaling ethnic group and sold into slavery. Once enslaved, she was shipped to Haiti. In Haiti, she was renamed Victoria Manto on a slave plantation, where she met her proclaimed nephew, Jean Dessalines, the future emperor of Haiti. Because of the love between them, Dessalines frequently referred to her as Auntie Toya. She was described as intelligent, energetic, and shared a very close relationship with Dessalines and the same hatred towards slavery. This union between a Mino warrior and the spirit of Emperor Dessalines proved to be unstoppable. Auntie Toya became the closest family member he knew. In her wisdom, Adbaraya saw the potential in the future leader of Haiti and began teaching him the art of fighting and hand-to-hand combat and even weaponry, showing the young Haitian prince how to throw a knife. This training from his beloved warrior auntie led him to become the great leader he was during the Haitian Revolution, and Adbaraya was fighting right alongside with him. Dessalines made her the leader of her own military unit, and she used her skills as a Mino warrior to train and guide her troops. The story of Adbaraya Toya and her beloved spiritual nephew, Dessalines, the Emperor of Haiti, is one of the greatest stories in the African diaspora, because it's a story about love, purpose, perseverance, and ultimate glory. Our warrior queen, Adbaraya Toya, carried the legacy of the Dayomi warriors on her back as she went on to see Emperor Dessalines proclaim Haitian independence. After her death, just 1 year after independence, a state funeral was held in her honor, and she was celebrated as the mother of Haiti's independence. It's absolutely remarkable that she held on just long enough to see an independent Haiti, and also to even the score with the French for her Dayoman ancestors. Well, I'm all out, guys. If you like these videos and want to help out in its continued production, you can do so on patreon.com. The link is in the description box below. Know thyself. Remember your ancestors. Peace.